crews traveled to an uninhabited island in search for ancient treasure. Many crew members were hurt while traveling the rough sea, but a piece of the map that they were using to find the ancient treasure was stolen when they arrived on the island.
We are the Visioneers. As we sailed to the coast of Indonesia, a crime was committed.
A piece of the ancient map was stolen.
There was also a powdery substance, blood splatter, and an overturned cup.
We are on a mission to help Captain Thomas find out who the traitors were and help the crewmates who are ill and injured.
Dr. Smart continued examining the crew and noticed that Chief Stewart has shortness of breath, wheezing, and accelerated heart rate. We created model lungs to figure out which treatment would be best.
Knowing how to identify fractures and dislocations that require urgent attention is a skill. In this station, you will learn how to make a cervical neck circular splints and an arm sling. Treating saves lives and limbs when the patient is far from a hospital.
Splints are good if you don't know if the patient is injured. If you're doing an exam and they start showing any incapable muscle movement, stop the exam right away and put on a splint.
The lungs are a key component in keeping a man or woman in alive and breathing. And when Sydney showed signs of wheezing, shortness of breath, Dr. Smart did an exam, and that exam showed how and why her lungs collapsed. After conducting an experiment of making a model lung and seeing how and why lungs collapse, we furthered Dr. Smart's knowledge of the lungs, and he dove in and took the surgery.
We also created an M-Bot. We connected the motors first, then the wheels. After that, we added the sensor.
Then we put the wheels
battery. We connected all the wires. Rescuing the shipwright Robert Neff, and it was Sydney,
first mate
Sydney.
The M-Bot
we programmed the M-Bot to go to a specific route
to make it through the island.
We made a bridge to help
the M-Bot
cross
to save the passengers.
The main component of keeping a human alive is part of the cardiovascular system. When the surgery opportunity came to Dr. Smart, he took the opportunity to expand our knowledge of the heart. He jumped in and saved the day when Sydney Young and Moore was experiencing in these symptoms: shortness of breath and wheezing. If you cut off the lungs, you basically cut off the heart.
Snake bites. The king cobra's venom is neurotoxic. Neurotoxic venom attacks the arteries, veins, and nerves. The effects are dizzy, bad eyesight, and loss of memory. The Malayan pit viper is hemotoxic. The hemotoxic venom attacks the bloodstream. And the effects are shortness of breath.
Do's and don'ts. Do. Calm down. Don't run around. Don't apply ice do, try to call 911. Don't suck out the venom. Do, elevate your wound. Do not apply pressure. Take a picture of the snake. First mate Cindy Young was in the middle of the jungle and
we discovered blood splatters at the scene of the crime.
Many people on the crew were injured. We found blood splatters, so we had to start analyzing at each different heights.
One at 4 at 12, 4 at 30, and 4 at 66.
We created blood splatter samples, drops from different heights to compare to the ones found at the scene of the crime.
After comparing our samples to the blood drop of the crime scene, we discovered that it was 30 inches high.
The average for 12 inches was 1 centimeter. The average for 30 inches was 1 centimeter also. The one with the average for 66 was 2 centimeters. That's why we concluded that it was Sydney Young's blood.
In our time here at STEM camp, we were assigned to solve a mystery. The mystery was the case of the missing map, and the suspects are
Dr. Nicholas Smart, first mate Sydney Young, navigator Howard Potter, and shipwright Robert Neff.
This week we discovered who did it. We discovered that by looking for fingerprints at the scene of the crime, shipwright Neff did it.
You may think that searching for fingerprints may be easy, but you have to be delicate.
Captain Thomas discovered a mysterious white powder in the cabin. To determine what the substance was, we did an experiment with various white powdery substances along with water and iodine. We figured out that the powder was cornstarch. Also, cornstarch can be used for sunburn and hiding fingerprints.
We used powdered sugar, cornstarch, baking soda, and